見てみ。あそこが丸目の旦那の言うてたとこやな。ああ。早いって休もうや。
なんや、まだ誰もおらへんやないか。ああ、わしらだけかもしれんな。生き残ったんは。ああ、しかしまさか敵があの結城秀康だったとはな。ほんま、えらいやつを切ってもうたで、あんた。
結城？何やお前、結城秀康を知らんのか。ああ、そりゃほんまの怖いもん知らずやな。ある意味さすがや。どういうことだ。
まあええ、説明したる。ゆっくり座って話そうや。
Alright, last time we learned that our target was Yuki Hideyasu, and Musashi successfully assassinated him. I could go into who he is or who he was, but Majima is actually going to talk a bit about that in a minute. For now, let's pick up some of the stuff around here. Items like this, the lapis lazuli, that's for weapon crafting later on. It's not a rare item. I mean, you can pick them up, win them in fights, buy them later on. But some of these things are, you know, might as well get them now. Spirit Elixir will help boost our heat gauge a small amount. Helps fill up the heat gauge. It doesn't raise the max or anything. It's the basic restoration item. A couple more things out here. One is this Heretic's Shard, another weapon crafting item. And some more medicine and stuff. Actually, all we had to do was just step outside the building and then step back in to trigger Majima to continue his story, but there is stuff to be found. Not allowed to go out the gate, though. And there's a little sparkly there on the left. Looks like it's another one of our little friends. So these early chapters all have a turtle in them, and it's the same deal as before. We can flip him over, help him out. He has a weird pattern on his back, and supposedly he may or may not help us in the turtle racing minigame later on. Alright, before we head back in, let's take a look at our menu a bit. We picked up some stuff in the last action stage, most important of which, we got a new sword. Now, right now, we're still using the Sakushu Tachi and the Sakushu Kodachi, and we have a Tokugawa Eastern Army armor, too, which we cannot take off. But let's switch up to our new sword. It's a little better. Blue is good, and it's called the Nameless Tachi, or the Nameless Katana, and slightly better. And one thing that's kind of cool about this game is that the weapons actually look different, even if just slightly. Although, I don't think there's enough different looks to account for the 200-and-something different weapons that actually are in the game. But you can see even the scabbard here on the model looks different. This one is a brown wooden one, the previous one was like a black lacquer finish.
あんたが切った結城秀康って男、ありゃ徳川家康の嫡男、つまり次の当主となるべき男や。 そうだったのか。
ああ。名前こそ勇気って名乗っちゃいるが、あれは徳川から養子に出されて仕方なくついた名前や。ほんまやったら東軍の総大将を務めててもおかしないほどの男やで。
だがそれほどの人間がなぜ養子に。
なんや、あの勇気秀康ってやつは出来が悪いって評判の男らしくてな、親父の家康にも嫌われて無理やり養子に出されたって噂もあるくらいや。
そのことを恨んで徳川を裏切ると。
まあそういうことやろな。そうでないとあの天海がわざわざこんなややこしい作戦立てて殺すようなことはせんやろ。どうしたんや。
え、あ、いや、あの結城という男、そんな悪い噂の立つような男には見えなかった。
え、
それに俺が部屋に入った時すでに襲われることを知っていたようだった。
なんやと。それじゃあ結城秀康は襲われること分かっといて逃げ出さんかったっちゅうことか。
そないなアホな話があるか。
わしやったら速攻逃げ自宅しとるで。
だがあの言葉気にならないか。
ん？あ、おう、天界から弟を救い出すとかなんとか言っとったやつか。
そうだ、あの結城という男どこか引っかかる。
まあな、でも考えすぎなんとちゃうか。天海と昔に揉め事でもあっただけなんちゃうか。しかしよう降るな。
変やな、ずいぶん時間が経つのに誰も来えへん。どないしたんや、暗い顔して。
いや、
なんやねんな、気になるがな。
俺は今日初めて人を斬った。
え、初めてって。お前そうか。お前それで怖なって。
いや、そうじゃないんだ。
え、
その逆だ。
お前、
俺は人を斬るということはもっと怖いものだとずっと思っていた。だが今はその怖さを感じない。あの結城って男にせよ、その手下にせよ、強い剣の前では無力。俺は改めて分かった気がした。剣とは人を斬るための道具だということ。つまり真の剣士とは剣で命の奪い合いを重ねることでこそ。
武蔵って言ったっけか、あんた。
ああ、
それはあかん。それは人斬りに取り憑かれた人間のセリフや。
人斬り。
せや、人を斬ることでしか自分の価値を見出せへん、そんな剣士の慣れの果てや。昔のわしもそうやった。
え、
Well, nothing to do but continue our conversation. So we learned a little bit about Yuki Hideyasu, our target. What they said was mostly true to life. He was the eldest living son at this time of Tokugawa Ieyasu, and he was given up for adoption to the Yuki family. supposedly because Tokugawa didn't like him, although reasons are not known. He did not die at Sekigahara. He continued living a few more years and died in 1607, and there is no suspicion that he was killed by Tokugawa or Tokugawa's forces or any kind of treachery. But yes, Tokugawa's second surviving son then did go on to succeed him and become the next shogun. Now we're learning about Majima. Majima used to be a shugyosha, that is, like a ronin who would wander around in this era, going to dojos and various samurai families that he had a reputation for great swordsmanship in order to improve his technique and to follow the so-called way of the sword. That was something that the real Miyamoto Musashi also did in his younger days. This was something you would do if you did not have a position in a samurai household, you weren't a retainer to a lord. Now we remember why Musashi accepted Marume's offer. Marume suggested that he might become a sword instructor to the Tokugawa family, which would be pretty much the highest position that a samurai not blood-related to the family could ever hope to reach, and something that pretty much any samurai would want. But it seems that Majima doesn't have that kind of thing in mind. Ukiyo, his sister, is waiting for him. And we've heard about Olmi before, Olmi province, a few times, but most recently, in the last chapter, Majima said that's where he got the reputation as Killer Gorohachi. Those who played Yakuza 2 will also recognize that the Olmi Alliance, or the Olmi Rengo, was the major crime family in the western Kansai Osaka area in that game. And that's because Olmi is located in that region of Japan.
わしは結局今の今まで剣を捨てることができんかった。せやけど、あんたならまだ引き返せる。人斬りの道に進む前に引き返すんや、武蔵ちゃん。無理だ。なんやと？俺は物心ついた頃から剣士を目指して生きてきた。今更国に帰っても
剣を捨てて生きていくことなんかできない。もう後戻りはできないんだ。せやけど、この先わしのような道をたどるかもしれへんで。分かってる。でも俺は純粋にもっと強いやつとも戦ってみたいんだ。そうか、ならえ。せやけど世の中広い。天下無双を目指すんやったら
先は長いで、覚悟はしている。お、やっと迎えが来たんか。やはりお前たちが生き残ってしまったか。生き残ってしまったって、あんた何言うとるんや。
マルメさん。
何の真似や。
あるべさ。どういうことなんだ?
お前たちはここで死ぬのだ。
So it's time to fight Marume again, and this time we have to beat him. A few things are different about this fight. We're using real swords, so we have heat actions available, and we have any of techniques we know available, except that we haven't actually learned anything since our last battle. We also have to face a few of his goons here, some of whom have items, healing items we can pick up. And we have Majima on our side. Now, he's pretty aggressive. He fights more or less like he did in the previous battle, or like he did when we faced him in a duel. And he can kind of get in some blows on the back, especially for Marume, because Marume will completely focus on Musashi. It's not a viable strategy to think that Majima is going to distract him while you run in and get him in the back. It's got to be the other way around. Majima doesn't do a lot of damage to him, but then neither do we, really, in this situation. Can't hurt Majima, he's completely invulnerable. And he can hurt the enemy, but we do need to land the final blow. They won't die, or at least Marume won't die from Majima's strikes. Now, Marume fights pretty much like he did in the previous battle, it's just that he has about two-fifths as much life, and he's not nearly as aggressive with the stun locking. He also doesn't charge in quite the same way as he did most of the time. You can see it right there, actually, but that's a little unusual in this fight. The most important thing, the thing that stops him from stun locking, is that Majima tends to stab him in the back while he's trying to chain you. But actually, the arena with the Buddha statue in the middle makes this a little more unwieldy than the dojo was. So I mentioned in the past that Marume was a real guy, and that's true. He would have been alive at this time, although the real Marume would have been around 60 years old. Now he's from Kyushu, which is the southernmost main island of Japan, not counting Okinawa. And he started his own school of swordsmanship, which was called the Taisha style. But he really didn't have any known connection to events around Sekigahara or the rise of the Tokugawa shogunate. So he's moderately obscure for a samurai or a swordsman, but they do try to make the characters in the game people who were sword masters or who started their own schools or styles in his era. Marume is one of the very few characters in the game that did not appear in the book, Musashi. Majima, of course, didn't. He's a staple from their Ryuga Gotoku series, but they changed his name up a little bit. In the other Yakuza games, he is known as Majima Goro, and that's his first name, Goro. But in this game, they changed it to Goro Hachi, and I suspect that's because he fills a role somewhat similar to one in the book. In the book, the story opens with a 16-year-old Musashi and his best friend, Matahachi, same-sounding suffix to the name as Majima's, escaping from the battle, the aftermath of the battle at Sekigahara, of course on the western side instead of the Tokugawa side. And in a lot of ways, his character is to Kiryu what Matahachi was to Musashi in the book. So his story arc won't go the same way or anything, you know, don't worry about spoilers, but I think that's what they were going for with that name change. Alright, now to tell the truth, you've probably noticed this really doesn't go any differently than the last fight did, and if you watch the bonus video, there's nothing going to happen here you haven't seen before. So feel free to go ahead and skip to around the 23-minute mark if you're tired of watching me whittle him down. And I'm not going to say anything vital or terribly interesting until then. Yeah.
control.
さすが私が見込んだだけのことはある。だがまだまだだな。丸目さん、説明してくれ。どうして俺たちを。何を手間取っているのだ。 丸め。小次郎様。おお。この男たちが結城秀康を切った者たちか。どちらが切った？俺だ。 そうか。それはご苦労だったな。だが、お前たちにはここで死んでもらう。その構え。
何のつもりだ。構わん。
やれ。
All right, we learned a new style. This is the dual sword style, a dual wield style with the tachi and kodachi. One of the most important features we're practicing now is that it can defend in a 360 degree arc all around you. So it stops everything, even arrows, everything except musket fire, but that's pretty rare, so we don't have to worry about that much. Can also do chain combos with square and triangle, just like with a single sword. And you can do Zanshin, charge up your heat gauge, although in this tutorial we're not able to use heat action. It's a little faster than the single sword style, but also a little weaker. And that only happened because I actually go with a button hit. But it's what Musashi, the real Musashi, is most famous for, is using the two swords together and starting his own technique in school with that. It's depicted in almost all media, including the book and this game, that he was the first one to do it, and it was completely unheard of. That's kind of a half-truth. He's not the only person who fought using two swords, and not the only school of swordsmanship to follow that style, but he did create his own. It's infinitely more famous and popular than any others. And it was an exceedingly rare idea. It was certainly not mainstream. I'll get into that a little more when we have more time in the future.
まさかそのような技を使うとはな。その技、本物かどうか。試させてもらうぞ。二刀流か。だがそんな小手先の技が私に通用すると思ってるのか。死に損ないが。なお、聞こう。
宮本武蔵、あんた、
佐々木小次郎だ。何の真似だ。観念したのか。
丸目さん、俺はあんたに言われた通り、逃げて生き延びる。生きてこの男とまた戦う。マジマ、
宮本武蔵か。